Now, today I am going to use this opportunity to help you to look at a CT abdomen. Now, CT abdomen is asked as a question to a lot of USMLE aspirants as well as people who are preparing for Indian PG entrance exam or even for residents. So, what I'll try to do is I'll look at a CT abdomen from a radiologist perspective and show you how to look at it. Now, we are starting with a contrast enhanced CT today, and you can look at in front of you. You can see you can see the chest, you can see the heart, you can see the lungs. How do you know lungs? Lungs are appearing black. You can see some pulmonary vessels showing contrast enhancement. Now, if I go beyond, even before you look at all this, please remember this is the right side, this is the left side, this is the anterior part, this is the posterior part. This is the sternum, ribs, and you can see the vertebral body, ribs. You can see the aorta, very often asked as a question also in our exams. And you can see this is the left atrium. This left atrium is the posterior most chamber in the heart. So this is how you identify left atrium. This is the left ventricle. You can see the wall is thicker than the right. You can see the right ventricle anteriorly placed just behind the sternum. And this is the area of the right atrium. Now, my advice to you is that whenever you start looking at the CT abdomen, do not forget to look at the lung bases. What I would always do is I would always look at the lung bases in lung window as well as in the mediastinal window, so that sometimes I've seen that if a patient has a even if they send the patient for a CT, abdomen, sometimes we discover some lung nodules or metastatic nodules sitting in the lung base. You should always, or pleural effusion, you should always look at the lung bases. That is the first thing to remember. Now, as we go down, you can see the left ventricle. You can see how the wall is thicker than the right, and we go downwards. You can see the aorta. Now, the important structure that we have to identify here is the esophagus. How do you know this is the esophagus? You can see a small speck of air in this collapsed muscular tube. That is the esophagus, and you can see the liver on the right side, and you can start seeing the spleen on the left side, along with the stomach. Along with the stomach. Now, as I go down. Now you can see how the esophagus is forming the G junction. You can see the stomach, and you can see the spleen, and you can see the heart still, and you can see the liver. So if this is the liver, this is the hepatic part of the IVC. So let me go back, look at trace the IVC. This is the inferior vena cava, inferior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and look at the aorta. So we are tracing the abdominal aorta here, and this is the G junction. So once we are able to follow this much, so we go downwards, and before we look at anything, just try and look at the attenuation, look at the appearance of the liver. Sometimes you may have a diffusely low attenuation liver, which is low density liver, which you see in a patient with fatty infiltration. And sometimes you may have a diffusely increased attenuation of liver, like a patient with hemochromatosis or a glycogen storage disorder, or sometimes you may have a patient with amiodarone toxicity where the liver would be high density, while in fatty infiltration, low density. So even before you look at the liver for any focal lesion, look at the attenuation of the liver and try and understand that what are we dealing with, an infiltrative process, or is it a focal lesion, is it a normal liver? Now, the focal lesions in the liver, the contrast CT that we are looking at now is very useful. The reason is because of the dual blood supply nature of the liver. We all know liver gets its blood supply from the portal vein and the hepatic artery, primarily from the portal vein. And this dual nature of blood supply helps us to, look at, now suppose you're looking at a metastatic lesion in the liver. So in the portal venous phase, you will be able to see that metastasis as a hypovascular area, until unless we are dealing with a hypervascular lesion. So that is where, this is a routine CT where we have done the CT scanning in the portal venous phase. But if you are suspecting a liver lesion, you can do a triple phase CT and scan the liver in the arterial phase, venous phase, and the parenchymal phase to look at the vasculature of the lesion. So contrast CT is very useful to assess and characterize the focal lesions in the liver. So every time you have to spend some time on the liver. So we always assess the liver if there is any focal lesion, look at the attenuation, look at the size, and you should also look at the gallbladder. This is the gallbladder. Now, the key thing to remember as an undergraduate would be that gallbladder is suboptimally evaluated by a CT scan. often we have seen the patient may have a gallstone, but the CT scan may come out to be normal. So do not miss out on looking at the gallbladder, but always remember ultrasound would be more superior to CT scan to evaluate gallbladder. And you should look at the portal radicals. You can see the right portal vein, the left portal vein. And if I trace the portal vein, you can see the portal vein. This is the main portal vein. And you can see, let me trace it. You can see this is the splenic vein. And how the splenic vein is, now if I show, this is the superior mesenteric vein. Superior mesenteric vein. The larger one is the vein, the smaller one is the artery. And it is joining the splenic vein and it is forming the main portal vein. You can see the portal vein. Then it is dividing into two parts. So this is how you can trace the portal vein in the CT scan. Always remember the orientation. This is the right side. This is the left side. So this is the spleen. You can see the stomach. So if I go down, now you can see the diaphragmatic crura and you can see the abdominal aorta. Abdominal aorta is something that an undergraduate is supposed to know. It is very often asked, very often asked. You cannot miss out on identifying the abdominal aorta. And if I go down, now you will be able to see, you can see the right kidney here. And this is the inferior vena cava. This is the portal vein. This is the aorta. This is the diaphragmatic crus. So between the liver, kidney, IVC, do you see this V-shaped area? This is the adrenal. This is the adrenal gland. So now if I go a little bit down, you can see, you can well appreciate the adrenal now. This is the adrenal and you can see the adrenal on the other side also. As a rule of thumb, usually the limbs of the adrenal should be approximately the size of the adjoining crus. So when do we call it enlarged? When it is larger than the adjoining crus, or if we see a focal lesion or a mass-like lesion. So this is the area where you look for the suprarenals. Okay. So once you're able to follow this, we go down and now you can see in this section a lot of anatomy. You can see the stomach, okay? You can see the stomach filled with fluid and you can see some air. And behind the stomach, can you see now? This is the pancreas. This entire area is the pancreas. So this is how a normal pancreas should look like. If it is edematous, you know, or there is pancreatitis, it will look bulky, heterogeneous. And look at the fat planes. So can you see how you can appreciate the peripancreatic fat planes? Had it been pancreatitis, you will see loss of the peripancreatic fat planes. You will see fluid density areas in the pancreas and you will see pancreas would be swollen. Now, if I show you the anatomy once more, this is the inferior vena cava. Okay, very often asked, this is kind of a default thing that you should know. And this is the aorta. This is the aorta. And if I go backwards now, can you see from the aorta? You can see how the celiac trunk is arising from the aorta. I go down. You can see the superior mesenteric artery. And what do you see here? Left renal vein crossing over, joint draining into the IVC. And I go down. And you can see the right renal vein draining into the IVC. And if you look at the aorta carefully, you can actually see the origin of the right renal artery here. So that is all possible with a CT scan. You can look at the renal artery, you can renal veins, and you can look at the kidneys. So it is, you can see how in this phase, you can see the corticomedullary differentiation of the kidney can be appreciated. And you can see both kidney, the cortex are showing homogeneous uptake of the dye. And now if I go down, okay, so what are we able to see? We can see the aorta, IVC, the kidney. So what is this structure that you can see here? This is the hepatic flexure. This is the hepatic flexure of the colon. I am going down. This is the ascending colon. And look at the other side. This is the descending colon. I go up. Splenic flexure, descending colon. And if you can follow the descending colon, you can actually follow it up to the, this is the sigmoid area. This is where you look for sigmoid diverticulitis or diverticulosis. This is the area of the sigmoid colon. And if I go down, this is the rectum. And these are the seminal vesicles. You can see the bladder in front. This is the anterior side, if you remember. You can see the hips. You can see the hip joints. I'm going down just to make sure that you follow. You can see the prostate. You can see the rectum. And you can see the surrounding fat and the levator, and I go backwards. Now let us trace the aorta. So if I trace the aorta now, look at the aorta. I'm tracing it. You see a ventral branch. I'm going down, 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 down. And you can see it will bifurcate into the two iliacs. Now I'm following the common iliacs, following the common iliacs. What are we able to see? You can see how it is going and going, and you can see how the iliac, you will see it is dividing, and you can see how it continues into the external iliac and the femoral veins, femoral arteries. Now if you trace the veins, so this was the artery, look at the IVC and see how you will see it dividing into the iliacs. So two iliacs are joining together to form the inferior vena cava. You can also evaluate the CT abdomen. It is always a good idea when you're looking at the CT abdomen, change the window to the bone window. Do scan through the patient to look at the bone. Sometimes you might get a bony lesion, or you might see a bony metastasis or an infective foci, which you might have missed otherwise. It is very important to look at the bone window and the lung window separately. Many times you will see the graduates will miss out on this. Another thing that is too important to look at is, please look at the body wall, look at the anterior abdominal wall. Sometimes you might discover hernias through the anterior abdominal wall. Look at the body wall, look for any abscess, any collection. Look at the body wall, look at the erector spinae group of the muscles. Look at the psoas muscle on both sides. Look at the iliacus muscle, compare them. So, and always look at the bladder. This is how it looks like. Look at the wall. It is uniformly thin walled. And look for any filling defect in the bladder. Look for any tumor, mass. So this is what we are doing to do in a CT scan. So always when we look at a CT scan, we try to, just like I'm doing in front of you, we try to take a gross overview of the CT. Then we look at the cardiac or the mediastinal area. Look at the lung bases. Look at the liver. Look at the attenuation, look for focal lesions, look for their vascularity, look at the portal, spinoportal axis, look at the inferior vena cava, aorta, adrenals, don't miss out on looking at adrenals. Look at the pancreas, how it looks like, this is how the appearance is, and this is how the size should be of the pancreas. If it is swollen, think of pancreatitis. If it is calcified, think of chronic pancreatitis. Pancreatic ductal dilatation, look for intrahepatic biliary radical dilatation. Do look at the gallbladder on CT, but with a pinch of salt, it could well have some pathology which a CT may not be able to appreciate, where you might need to get an ultrasound done. And look at the spleen. In patients with abdominal trauma, this spleen is often injured. Look at the aorta, inferior vena cava, renal veins, look at both the kidneys and try to look for symmetry. And you can see surrounding the kidney, you will be able to see some fat, which is normal. This is how it looks like. And we follow it up till the end. Look at the pelvis, bladder, seminal vesicles, prostate, rectum. Now you can also look at the CT in a coronal reconstruction manner. This is a coronal reconstruction of the CT. Today with CT, we have a capability of multi-planar reconstructions. So when you do a coronal reconstruction, you can see the lung bases very well. You can see the heart. You can see the liver very well here. You can see the portal vein, and you can see the stomach here. I'm going anterior. You can see the spleen now. And this is the section that they would usually ask you. These are the kidneys. You can see the left kidney, liver, spleen. You can see both the psoas muscles. And I am now going anterior. I'm coming from posterior to anterior. You can see the colon here. You can see the colon. I am coming posteriorly. I'm moving my images, and you can see this is the gallbladder that we saw on the axial images. And look at the vasculature. This is the aorta, and this is the inferior vena cava. This is the hepatic part, and see how it is going into the right atrium. And do make sure that after you have looked up at CT, we do a delayed section, that is to look at the kidneys in the excretory phase. So now this is the delayed phase where you can see excretion of the dye in the kidneys. You can see the pelvic alveolar system. You can see the ureters. You can trace the ureters. Can you see them anterior to the psoas? Trace the ureters. I'm able to trace them. And there you can see them entering the bladder, and you can see how now the bladder has become opacified because the dye has been excreted into the urinary bladder. So again, to revise for you, always try to look at the CT abdomen from initially, just scan the entire image just so that you get a broad idea of what are you dealing with. Then look at each organ with a checklist in mind. Look at the abnormalities of size, look for focal lesions, look for attenuation difference. Look at pancreas, look, try to look at the entire pancreas, look at ductal dilatations. Look at how the vessels are enhancing, look for filling defects in the vessels. And you should also look for the normal sizes of the organs. For example, we talked about the adrenal, look at the aorta, and we are going down, we're going down. And this is how the entire CT abdomen looks like. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of our attempt to create a teaching video on evaluation of CT abdomen. And I've tried to give you a brief overview of the anatomy. What I feel is this overview of the anatomy is more than enough for people who are appearing for step 1 USMLE, or if they're appearing for NEET PG exam. Most of the time people do not have an orientation on the sides. They are not able to diagnose situs inversus on a CT image which is shown to them. So you should always know on a CT scan, the side where you are seeing me is the right side and the other side is the left side. That is very important to remember. Look at the side, look at the bones. If you are a resident, my message to you is don't miss out on looking at the lung window and the bone window as well. So sometimes the pathology might be in the lung basis or in the bones. That is very important to see. I hope you enjoy this. Keep looking out for more such educational videos on the DAMS Daily channel on YouTube. Do subscribe to us and do let me know if you enjoy this episode. Thank you.